Fact 2601, and my name is Andre Eisley, and I will be presenting to you the financial accounting for leases for tonight. Just for our house rules, yet again, please note that the there will be a delay in the message coming through, and about 30 seconds or 40 seconds delay, I will be potentially on another slide before you can actually start hearing me. But just some house rules. We've got a question and answer section that you can send some questions through. I will give a break of about 10 minutes after the very first part of leases, which we will deal with short-term leases. So we basically only going to discuss short-term leases and financial leases that is covered in your lesson tool 7. Just a quick thing, our contact details, Alfred Baloy is our module leader, Chris McKeever, one of our lecturers, myself and Frank Montgomery, and you can reach a dedicated mailbox for any of your questions on fact2601@unisa.ac.za. Now, colleagues, tonight's session is really about discussing leases, how you would approach it, how you will deal with it, and how you will apply it in any given questions that will come up in your elective assessment 3, as well as your big assessment, the written assessment that's pointed or that's scheduled for the 15th of May. Now, before we continue on that, let me quickly take you to our module course page, where everything is discussed in your welcome message. And please read again through our welcome section, where we explain the changes in our current assessment strategy. We brought in an elective assessment 3, which is also an MCQ, which also counts 30%. And this is for specifically for those people that feel that they want to improve their marks for assessment 2. And if they've missed assessment 2 for a matter of fact, and it will cover lessons tools 3 to 8. So this is an MCQ question, about 20 questions dealing from lessons tools 3 to 8. So it's really there to benefit you if you want to improve your marks. And that will take place the 2nd of May 2024 from 6 to 9 on the exams platform. All right. So the exams platform is where you've written your assessment 2. That assessment will only open on the 2nd of May from 6 to 9, and it will cover the lessons tools 3 to 8, as you can see on the screen here. So please, colleagues, this assessment is really there to benefit you if you, for example, missed your assessment 2 and you want to improve your marks. And the highest of the two, either for assessment 2, 3 and 5, your year mark will only consist of 4 assessments and obviously will take the highest mark of the MCQs marks. Okay. Colleagues, having said that, let's go back to our current session for tonight, which is leases. And I need to emphasize the fact that it's very important that you understand the theory. Colleagues, I can't emphasize this enough, but you need to work through your study material, learning unit 7, and all the material is of utmost importance for you to understand the theory and how will we apply it. I will take you through literally a very small section of the theory and will show you how we apply the theory on given questions, because that is ultimately what we are after. But you have to understand the theory, and you will also see that for leases, the second session that we will do after the first hour, when we deal with financial leases, how it is critically important to know the theory and how you will apply it. And I will guide you with my presentation slides today, as well as going through the typical questions that you can expect from us with applying the theory to given questions. So, colleagues, I cannot go through the theory with you. You can read, your adults, you can interpret these things. I will highlight certain things for you that will make it easier. But you must remember that when you come to a third year level, it is more a theoretical discussion type of questions that you need and must be able to apply on questions. So you must understand the theory to be able to apply it in certain discussion type questions, because when your career is aspiring to become a CA, it's moving towards more discussion type of questions. And if you can get the basics right here, you shouldn't have any problems, or you can't have any problems going forward. Now, colleagues, I'm not going to go through the framework here, the theory. Let me get back to the slides. Yet again, the slides will be made available under your facet section. If we could quickly go back towards your the My Module site, you will see that the My Module site in your Moodle platform, where we give you the facet class section, and I will post for you your videos here. You won't be able to see it now because this is hidden from you, and I will give you the slides and the questions here under the facet section. That is my aim for tonight, to post the things here, and that you can find this under your facet section. All right, colleagues, let's get straight into the power presentation slide for tonight, so that we don't waste any more time to continue for your short-term leases. The very first part is leases consist of low-value assets. And again, you must have a good understanding of the theory and know how to apply it in any given scenario. Therefore, it is imperative that you work through the theory in the lesson tool 7, where I've just been in your notes. All right. So from there on, you can see clearly how you will approach a question, a discussion type of question, and what do you need to apply for short-term leases. Now, for your short-term leases, the purpose for part one of low-value assets, we speak about it as recognition exemptions. The purpose of this presentation is really to discuss in two parts the difference between low-value and short-term leases versus the right-of-use assets when we deal with financial leases. You must remember that when we talk about short-term leases, we will tell you in the exam that a given question is of low value, as you can see there, and whether or not the company applies the recognition exemption to its low-value assets and short-term assets. Now, colleagues, excuse me. When we deal with the theory on page 14 of leases, you will notice that the lessee will recognize the lease payments associated with the lease as an expense on a straight line basis over the lease term, or another systematic basis if it is more representative of the pattern of the lease benefit. Now, let's just go quickly back to our study material where just hang on for a moment, where you need to go and read through the introduction part as to what is a lease, what defines a lease in a contract. For now on, that is exactly what I don't want to stress you about, because you can deal with this in your own time. I want to come straight to a question where we can discuss whether a contract contains a lease or not. All right. So this is exactly what you are after. That's why I said I'm not going to go through the definitions. You can read that by yourself. I really want to show you, by way of a question, how do you apply the theory to a question? Now, let's take, for example, the very first example in your study material for leases, where we say Sunshine Limited, the lessee, entered into a contract with Energex, lessor, to rent a property space for 20 squares of Energex 100 square meter property to sell its solar panels for a period of 3 years. Energex Limited has the right to change the location allocated to Sunshine at any time during the period. So Energex being the lessor and Sunshine the lessee, associated with changing the space used by Sunshine. Sunshine makes a use of a mobile truck, which it owns, to sell solar panels that can easily be moved. Sunshine will pay Energex 8,500 Rand per month to make use of property space. Now, according to this information, you need to discuss, excuse me, whether this contract contains a lease. Now, by way of the theory, if you went through the theory, this is how you will apply the theory to the given question. Okay? As per IFRS 16 leases, a contract contains a lease when the contract conveys the following: the right to control the use of an identified asset for a period of time in exchange for consideration. Now, let's look at the discussion of the lease definition components. Colleagues, this is coming directly from the standard. If you have read it in the beginning of this study material, the right to control the use of an identified asset as per IFRS 16 leases is a contract conveys the right to control the use of an identified asset when the customer has both of the following: the right to obtain substantially all economic benefits from the identified asset and the right to direct the use of the identified asset. That is the right to control the asset. The contract specifies the amount of property space that Sunshine Limited is entitled to use of the entire property space owned by Energex. However, the property space is not fixed. As a result, there is no identified asset. All right? Because why? Energex can determine whether what to use the change in location allocated to Sunshine. So therefore, there is no identified asset here. Okay? So having said that, even though Sunshine controls its own mobile truck, the contract of is for property space on Energex property and has the right to change the property space allocated at any time. Sunshine therefore does not control the asset because Sunshine does not have substantially all the economic benefits from the property space. Energex could benefit economically from substituting the property space, as there are minimum costs involved in moving the mobile truck by Sunshine, and Energex benefits from substituting the property space as its own property for something else that will be most effective. Energex has the right and practical ability to change the property use by Sunshine at any time during the entire period, thereby directing the use. For a period of time, the contract is for a 3-year period. Yes, that's true. In exchange for consideration, Sunshine will pay Energex an amount of 8,500 Rand per month. Conclusion: there is no identified asset, and Sunshine does not have the right to control an identified asset. Not all the conditions have been met. As a result, the contract does not contain the lease. Now, colleagues, you can read, you can apply this given information as long as you understood what an identified asset is and when you can identify a lease according to IFRS 16 standard. Now, this is according to the theory and how you will apply it in a discussion type of questions. That's why I told you from the beginning, remember that you can be approached by a discussion type of question. For now, we will give you a question and you need to apply the theory concerning calculations with regards to short-term low-value assets. And I'm getting to that right now. Okay? So for short-term leases, you will see when we deal with a given question how you will approach short-term leases. Colleagues, let me just stop there for 1 second. I just want to go back to see if can you all hear me? And I'm audible, and you can see the slides. I know that there is a slight delay, but can anyone see me and hear me? If someone can just send me a message there with regards to, yes, I'm audible as such. Okay, let me just double check quickly on the questions. Okay. All right. Before we continue, I just want to check quickly something. Yes, thank you. Thank you, Anonymous. I can hear you. questions, let me go quick directly back to our slides where you will see exactly when we deal with a given question. So it's critically important again that the theory is important for applying it to the given questions. Okay. Sorry, let me just get back to the slides here. okay. Now, whether there's a straight line, sorry. Let me just get my escape. I just want to get the quickly the where is my pointer? Sorry, hang on. Thank you. All right. Okay. So, colleagues, when we go through your the straight line method, you will see what I'm talking about when we will deal with short-term leases where the straight line basis is used and cash flows are not equal. The difference between the cash flows and the expense in the statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income will end up in the statement of financial positions as an accrued or prepaid expense. All right, that's for short-term leases, but I will show you what is meant with this by looking at a given question. All right, so colleagues, let's go directly to our first question dealing with short-term leases. Again, this is a question that you can being approached with, and this is exactly what we are after dealing with short-term leases, and we will do another question that's a little bit more in detail of something that you can expect either an assessment 4, which is the written assessment, as well as an assessment 3, where you need to perform short calculations. Now, let's look at this question, which will actually interpret the theory for you. And I can take you back to the slides where I can indicate to you what was meant with a straight line basis and the equalization method. All right. So again, this example is dealing with low value assets, which is the first part of our lease discussion. All right, colleagues, let's enter into this discussion where we can show you what this is all about. ACCA Limited entered into a contract with Beta and make use of a specialized printer and computer starting on 1st of January 2017. The contract meets the requirements of a lease in terms of IFRS 16 leases, and the asset is classified as a low value asset. Can you see here? Here we have already given you the fact that you are dealing with a low value asset. As I explained in my slides, we will, for exam or assessment preparation, we will tell you that this is of a low value asset and it's a lease in terms of IFRS 16. ACCA Limited make use of the recognition exemption in terms of IFRS 16 and leases for all short terms and low value assets. Now, the terms of the contract are as follows. Remember, what are we trying to do here? I'm trying to show you, according to a question, how we will apply the theory to a given question and then address all calculations as well as with discussion purposes. All right. So this is exactly what we are after dealing with a question where you can see how we apply the theory to the question. So the lease term of the lease are as follows. The lease term consists of 4 years. There's an initial payment of 1,440 rand, installments payable monthly in arrears, which is months 1 to 24 is 800 rand, and months 25 to 48 is 600 rand. That is your physical cash flow amounts. That is the amounts that you will pay to your lessor. Remember, in accounting, when we deal with payments that are on a cash flow basis, we say no, we need to bring payments into consideration based on the accrual basis of principle, meaning that we will equalize this payments, this cash flow payments, not what you pay according to the bank, but according to your accrual principle. You take into consideration things that happen throughout the year, during the year, on an equalized term. That is why for short-term leases, we have a statement that's called that no, we cannot take this 800 and 600 cash flow payments. We need to equalize the payments over the period to get a payment for accounting purposes, okay? Not based on the cash flow purposes, all right? So from what you can see here is that we're going to pay this lessor. We are the lessee, ACCA, and we entered into a contract with Beta. But they informed us that, wait a minute, you're going to pay 1,440 Rand up front. That's just to secure the lease. Then you're going to pay us 800 Rand for the first 24 months and 600 Rand for the 48 months. That's your physical cash flow. So you, what is going out of your bank is going to go 800 Rand for the first 24 months. And then you're still going to pay 600 Rand for the next 24 months. But colleagues, for accounting purposes, we will not account for that on that perspective. We will equalize based on the total term, and then we will account for that based on our equalized term, okay? So the lessee incurred 500 Rand legal fees for negotiating the lease, and the useful life of the computer and printer is 3 years, all right? So what does this question asks from us? It is important to note that when you address any question, you always go to the required first, especially when you are going to write your assessment for. It is imperative that you go to the required first to know exactly what is required from you. And then you can plot that down. For interest sake, if they ask from you in question two, please go and prepare the statement of financial position. What can you go and do? You can immediately go and draft the statement of financial position with the template or format that you've prepared beforehand, okay? That saves you time, okay? But if you don't go and read the required, what do you know is expected from you if you start from the top? I have started from the top now here because we are just dealing with a simple question on leases. But normally, whenever you open up a question paper, you will go to your required first and read what is required from you. So to engage you with what is expected from you. So having said that, the question states here, discuss the accounting treatment of ACCA for the year end 2017, December year end. It's important to note, what is your year end term year? It's 31st December. Then calculate the equalized monthly installments. Calculate the prepaid expense, okay, of 31st December, and then the prepaid expense or accrued expense as at 31st December. Discuss the low-value lease asset in the following notes to the annual financial statements of ACCA for the year ended, prepaid expense and IFRS 16 leases. Your answers must comply with the international financial reporting standards and ignore any income and tax and VAT implications. Colleagues, yes, the theory introduced completely into a question. This is exactly what you want, okay? So this is how we're going to deal with the solution. Colleagues, what is required from us is to discuss the accounting treatment of this lease. So as per IFRS 16 leases, a lessee may elect to apply the recognition exemption to short-term leases, because it's of low value assets. That's why the short-term leases are normally less than 12 months and is of low value, less than $5,000. That's actually coming directly from your theory. It is the policy of ACCA to apply the recognition exemption to all short-term and low value assets. As per IFRS 16, leases of low value assets are accounted for on a lease by lease basis. That means on a systematic basis, on an equalized term, okay? How do we recognize the leases? Well, when the recognition exemption is applied, the lessee will recognize the lease payments on a low-value asset lease as an expense on a straight-line basis over the lease term. Another systematic basis, it is more representative of the pattern of the lease benefit. That is how we will recognize the lease, by using the straight line basis. By how do we use the straight line basis? By equalizing the lease term. The question states from us that the question that asks from us is the fact that we need to rent this unit, this printer, property printer, okay, for a period of 48 months. How will we recognize this printer, this specialized printer? Well, systematically over the complete period, but according to our straight line basis, which is an equalized method, okay? So that is your short-term leases. That is the recognition criteria. The lessee will only consider the lease to be a new lease when there is a lease modification or there is a change in the lease term. Colleagues, this is applying the theory to the given question. So if we ask from you, please discuss what is the accounting treatment of. What do you need to discuss? You need to discuss whether the lease applies the short-term leases by way of low-value assets and applying the recognition exemption. Well, the question stated that to you when we said this is the ACCA makes use of the recognition exemption. Then secondly, you need to state how will you recognize short-term leases. Well, short-term leases are recognized for exemption based on a straight line basis over the lease term, or whether there's a systematic basis of it is more representative of the pattern. Now, in this scenario, it will be straight line basis over the lease term because we've gave you the lease term for 48 months. And the lease will only consider the lease to be a new lease when there is a modification. Then, colleagues, you'll reach a conclusion. The lease payments for low value assets must be recognized as an expense on a straight line basis over the lease term for 4 years as ACCA elected to make use of the recognition exemption. Now, that is the applying the theory to the given question. That is how you will outline the theory to the question on the given scenario. This will be typically exactly the same for any given question when we ask of you how you will discuss the accounting treatment for short-term leases. Now, colleagues, let's go to the calculations. Let me put them straight to one another. Then you can see exactly how we calculate these type of questions based on the information given. They ask from us, please calculate the equalized monthly installments. Well, how do we do that? Okay, well, the initial payment is 1,440 Rand, and we take the initial payment, 1,440 Rand. That's basically to secure the lease. The lessor asked of you to make an initial payment of 1,440 Rand, and we've done that. There is the initial payment, 1,440 Rand. What are the installments? Well, for the very first 24 months, we're going to pay 800 Rand. So what do? We say 24 times 800 gives you 19,200. What are we after here? We are after to calculate a monthly equalized payment for our accounting treatment. Because our recognition exemption, our recognition of accounting treatment states, this is the standard that tells us that you must recognize these lease expenses over a straight line basis over the lease term. That is what we are determining here now. So therefore, we bring in all the payments for the months. Can you see 1,440? We multiply 24 over 800 for the very first 24 months. And then the next 24 months, we apply 600 Rand, and that's 14,400 Rand. Now, we've got the total lease amount over the period of 48, okay? So because there's 48 months, then we take the 35,040 and we divide by 48 to get a equalized accounting treatment according to the system, the straight line basis, okay? That is what the standard tells us to do. That is how we apply the theory to the question. So therefore, colleagues, that is the amount for our accounting treatment, not the cash flow basis of 800 Rand. Now, let me quickly take you back to our slides. Can you see the cash flow is 800 Rand, but our equalized amount is less, is 730 Rand. Now, our our slides indicated that where the straight line basis is used and cash flows are not equal, the difference between the cash flows and the expense in the statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income will end up in the statement of financial position as an accrued or prepaid expense. I have summarized it like this. If the actual payment, lease payments, are more than the equalized amount, you've got a prepayment. So basically, when the actual cash flow lease payment in our scenario, when the actual cash flow payment, the 800 Rand, that's the cash flow payment, is more than the 730, the equalized amount, you will sit with a prepayment. The difference is a prepaid balance. This is exactly what I say here. The opposite is also true. When the cash flow payment is less than the equalized, you sit with an accrual. Now, I will take you directly back to the question to show you how we are dealing with this. Now, colleagues, they ask from us, excuse me, they ask from us to calculate the equalized monthly installments is calculated. Please prepare the equalized monthly installments. So we've calculated the equalized monthly installments. Okay, so we got the total of the total value. Remember the initial payment, the cash flow for the first 24 months, the cash flow for the second 24 months, the total value divided by 48. Why 48? Because that's the lease term. We are leasing it over 48 months. Okay, that is the initial payment and monthly installments. That is your 48 terms. Okay, your term is the 48 months, which is gives you your 4 years. Colleagues, then the implication of the equalization of lease payments is that a portion of the lease payments will be a prepaid expense or accrued expense in the statement of financial position. But how? How is that possible? Let me show you. Okay, colleagues. Let me show you how that is possible. Well, the initial payment, what did they ask from us? Calculate the prepaid expense or accrued expense as at 31st December 2017. Let's go and determine that. Okay, at the end of the first year, 31st December 2017, that is now for the very first 12 months, as you can see there. And remember, our year end is 31st December 2017. Now we're going to determine the prepaid expense. Well, we've paid 1,440 Rand for the initial payment. Our initial installments for the first year, remember, only 12 months, not 24 months now. So because we are now after the prepaid balance in the financial statement, is 9,600 Rand. That's 800 times 12 gives you 9,600 Rand. The total lease installments paid in cash for the year is 11,040. Okay, that is 11,040 Rand, the cash flow that took place in the first year when you leased the specialized printer. But according to our accounting treatment, we had to pay only 730 Rand according to our equalized amount based on the straight line basis over the lease term, because the standard tells us to do that. Okay, so that is why if you take 730 times 12, you only get 8,760 Rand. Therefore, can you see the cash flow is more than the equalized amount according to our slides? Okay, when the actual cash flow payment is greater than the equalized amount, you've get a prepayment. Therefore, in the slides, can you see the cash flow is more than the equalized amount? Therefore, there's a prepaid balance that will sit in your statement of financial position as an asset under your current assets. Okay, so why is that? Colleagues, we have paid more than what we should have. Therefore, there's an asset. Okay, so we've paid more, but we only must have paid 8,760. Why is that? The fact is that we, according to the standard, IFRS 16 tells us, no, you can't take the cash flows. You must equalize it over the term to be more consistent according to the straight line method. That is why you can't bring in the cash flow. It's not based on the cash basis, but it's based on the on the equalized amount of 2280. And you've already paid initial direct costs of 500 Rand, which is legal fees. And I will show you how to deal with this. Now, this is the journals, colleagues, to bring in. Remember, you paid an initial direct cost of the lessee of 500 Rand for negotiating the lease. That is initial direct cost is 500 Rand and credit bank. You paid it cash, 500 Rand. Here is your lease journals for the very first year, 31st December 2017. Okay. Your lease expense, what is the expense that's going through your profit and loss statement, your statement of comprehensive income, statement of profit, loss, and other comprehensive income? That is the expense that's going through to your income statement, not the cash flow amount. Well, that is 730 times 12 gives you 8760. That is your lease expense. What did you physically pay? Well, you paid the first 1,440 and 12 times 800 Rand. Where do we get 12 times 800 Rand? Well, that is your initial payment. 800 Rand for the first 2 years. Remember, we are dealing now with the very first year of 2017, accounting for the first year of lease payments, and therefore is 11,040. But you also created an asset, a prepayment. That is why we said when the equalized lease payments are less than the physical cash flow payment, you will sit with the prepayment, okay? And that is why there will be a balance amount of 2280 as a prepaid balance in your statement of financial position. Okay, colleagues, I will show you now how do we disclose it, okay? For 31st December 2018, how do we calculate that? Again, you've paid the bank 12 times 800. Remember now, this is the next 12 months in that given period, 24 months. We're dealing now with the other 12 months for 2018. So what is the lease expense according to our straight line method? Is 730 times 12 is 8,760. Can you see it? It's exactly the same because we are applying the equalization method for the accounting treatment recognition criteria according to the straight line basis over the lease term. That is why we have calculated 730, okay, as 8760. And in the second term, we've got 800 Rand. So why is that now only 840 and not the same as this 9,600 not the same as that 11,040? Because remember, we had an initial payment also in the first year of 1,440. In the second year, we only apply the cash flow that's physically going out of your bank account, which is 9,600. Can you see the difference? The cash flow amount is more than the equalized amount. Therefore, you will sit with another prepaid balance of 840, and that will increase to 3,120 because it's 2280 plus 840 will give you your 3,120 in your prepaid asset balance. Now, colleagues, at the end of the second year, this is your calculation to determine your prepaid balance in the statement of financial position section. Okay, here is an explanation of the prepaid expense versus the accrued expense. A company will recognize a prepaid expense for lease payments when the actual annual lease payments paid exceeds. That is what I'm telling you. The cash flow amount is greater than the equalized amount. You will sit with a prepaid expense. The opposite is also true. If the cash flow amount is less than the equalized amount, you will sit with an accrual. Okay? So it's basically just the opposite. Okay, colleagues? This is now how we will disclose the information in the notes to the annual financial statements, okay? What is the prepaid expense in the 2017 year? Well, it's a low value asset lease, the prepaid expenses, calculation 2 and calculation 3. Here is the calculation 2 and calculation 3, okay? So how did we determine that? Well, it's the 2280 is the prepayment. That's the difference between your cash flow amount and the equalized amount. When the cash flow amount is more than the equalized amount, you will sit with a prepayment. When the cash flow amount is less than the equalized amount, you will sit with an accrual. Then that prepaid expenses will fall under not assets, but current liabilities, okay, as an accrued expense. Okay, so this is the notes to the annual financial statements on the prepaid expenses for your statement of financial position. This is your expenses relating to your low value assets. Okay, ACCA Limited elected the recognition exemption on low value leases of offices equipment. The expense is the equalized installment of 8760. That is your lease expense for accounting treatment that's going through the statement of your profit and loss and other comprehensive income under your expense amounts. Okay, other operating expenses. That is where you will disclose your income and expense items related to leases for expenses. Recognition exemption. The computer and printer are not recognized as a right of use asset. As a result, no depreciation is recognized for low value assets. Okay, because this asset does not become your asset in your fixed asset register, you cannot write off depreciation. You cannot now go and recognize a printer on your books as an asset and depreciate the printer because this is a low value asset. You will never own this asset. You're only renting it. Colleagues, this is exactly how you will apply the theory on a given question. And I'm going to dive directly into another question because before I will summarize this question. You must remember that I will also put these questions with the explanations here under the facet section of our module. And it will appear rightly under the facet section here, where I will attach for you all the questions and the presentation slides here. All right. I want to quickly now go to another question that's a little bit more in detail so that you can see how we approach a different question that was asked in an exam, which is a little bit adjusted. Okay. This is some of the examples that you can expect either in your written exam or upcoming exam where you will need to deal with a solution or by calculating, okay? By calculating certain items. All right, what I'm going to do is let me minimize this one first and go directly to the question so that we can look at this question and work it out from the start. Okay, colleagues, the scenario will be given to you as such. If you get a question and you will go directly to the required and we must apply, you must apply the recognition exemption on this given scenario to determine where you will bring in leases. Okay, so we will give you a trial balance. And we will give you information that's related to a year end. In this scenario, it's 28th of February, 2021. And you immediately will look, when you deal with leases, you will immediately go and look for lease payments. Here is lease payments of 24,000 Rand. Okay, that is recognized in your trial balance. And that is according to note 3. Now, in this requirement, this question would have stated something about draft the statement of profit and loss and other comprehensive income for the year. And inside the question, you would have come to something like this. Okay. Nkobu entered into a lease contract. Remember, the lease payments indicate to you the note where you can find information about this lease payments of 24,000 Rand. We need to go and determine whether that 24,000 Rand is now correct or not correct. Okay, so here the question directed you towards note 3. Let's go to note 3. Nkobu entered into a non-cancelable lease on July 2020 to lease printing machine for the use of the company, and the contract is a lease in terms of IFRS 16. Well, we know we're going to apply the IFRS 16 standard here. Remember, immediately when you get something like this, you can write next to yourself equalization. Okay, you can also note down the cash flow year, the initial payment 8526. The lease payments are 3,000 Rand per month for the first 6 months. Colleagues, that is now where we start bringing in the cash flows for the short-term leases. Can you see that we have already initial cash flow amount of 8,526? The lease payments are 3,000 per month for the first 6 months. Now, let me give you a very good tip here. Okay, look carefully here, and this is also where you apply the theory to the question. Please note here, the year end is 28th of February 2021. Okay, something to note here quickly. Okay, but have you read with me that we entered into a lease on the 1st of July 2020, not from the beginning of the year? Okay, note that. Make a note of the term year. This is going to be critical to your information, to your calculations. Okay, so can you see we entered into the lease 6 months, July or 8 months? What's it? July, August, September, October, November, December, January, February. It's 8 months. So we've only started with this lease with 8 months. Keep that in your back of your mind. Let's go back to the calculation. Okay. The lease payments thereafter are 2,000 rand per month until the end of the 3 years. So can you see that your first cash flow is only 3,000 per month for 6 months? And then the rest is 2,000 per month until the end of the 3 years. All actual lease payments made by Mkombo are included in the operating expenses above. Okay, so it's included in the operating expenses above. Colleagues, let's go and discuss what comes next. Mkombo has the option to extend the lease term by a further 2 years of 1,000 rand. So there's an option of extending this lease by 1,000 rand. Will it exercise it or not? Let's look at it. At the commencement of the lease, Mkombo LTD is reasonable certain that it will exercise the option to extend the lease term by a further 2 years. So now you know that this lease term is initially for 3 years, but this guy is definitely going to extend it for 2 years. So we need to do something with this 1,000 rand. Then 5% of every lease payment goes towards covering the maintenance costs incurred by and is to be paid for by the lessor. So there are maintenance expenses that goes into this lease, and we need to deal with this maintenance expenses on somehow. Mkombo elected to apply the recognition exemption. Again, here we state what is the accounting treatment for this company that they've applied the recognition exemption and account for the lease on the lease by lease components separately. Now, this is where we will bring in the solution for you to clearly see how we deal with this. And again, I will post this on the Moodle site, on the module platform under the facet section. Okay, colleagues, let's go. This is the disclosure requirements, and we want to come to the calculations of determining how we deal with this question. Okay, let me just increase it a bit. Maybe make it about 85%. Okay, colleagues, let's go and deal with the terms of the respective lease contract. Can you see, again, we have got an initial payment of 8,526. That's a cash flow that took place. Okay. Then the first 6 months is 3,000 because the standard tells us that for the very first 6 months, you're going to pay a 3,000 rand. That's the cash flow that took place. It's 3,000 times 6 gives you 18,000. Again, we are applying the accounting standard IFRS 16 to the given scenario by determining the equalized amount. We need to come to the equalized amount. Remember that this contract is initially for 3 years, but we need to add a further 2 years. So it's 5 years. The contract term is over a period of 5 years. And I told you we need to take cognizance of the fact of the 1st July. Okay, so here we go. The initial payment was 8,526. The first 6 months is 3,000 times 6 is 18,000. And the next 30 months, 2,000 times 30 months, which is the end of the 3 years, gives you 60,000 rand. Okay, 2,000 times 30 months is 60,000. Okay, and there's an extendable option of 1,000 rands for 24 months, which is 24,000 rand. Okay, you add that up, then you get 110,526. But according to what the standard tells us, there is 5% needs to go towards maintenance that is incurred for and paid by the lessor. But we need to make provision for that maintenance expense of the contract cost that we will pay monthly. How do we do that? Well, we take the maintenance costs, which is the total value of the contract, and we say 110 times 5%, we deduct that from the initial contract term, because that 5526 is something that we might need to make maintenance a provision for, which is paid by the lessor, and we deduct that from our contract terms, okay? Is 5526, then we get 105,000 and we equalize it over the 5 years. Okay, 5 years, 105 divided by 5 is 21,000 rand. That is the total value for the first year. But remember, I told you that we only started in year one on the 1st of July 2020. Our year end is 28th of February 2021. So can you see the very first lease expense to be disclosed is not 21,000, but is 21,000 times 8 over 12, because we've only secured this lease on the 1st of July. July, August, September, October, November, December, January, February will give you 8 over 12. And our first equalized leased amount is 14,000 rand. Now, colleagues, can you see that our actual lease payments, the cash flow amount for the first year, what is it? Well, it's 8526, which is the initial payment. It's the 18,000 for the first 6 months. Okay, hang on, but where does this 4,000 come from? Well, from the 6 months, we've had it for 8 months in the current year. So what is 2,000 times 2 is 4,000 rand for the first year. Can you see how important it is to note the date? Because when we initially engage in this lease, the contract terms told us, but wait for the first 6 months, which brings us up to December, you're going to pay 3,000 rand. The next 2 months thereafter, you will pay 2,000 rands for 30 months, but two of those months falls within our current financial year, ending the 28th of February 2021. That is why you've got the initial payment of 8526 plus the 18,000. Where does the 18,000 come from? Is 3,000 times 6 gives you your 18,000. Okay, and then 2,000 rand for the very first 2 months ending at the end of 28th February 2021. That gives you your lease, your cash flow amount of 35,000. Now, of the cash flow amount, we will pay 5% towards maintenance fees, which is 1,526. That is why we debit your maintenance expense. This is now for your journal entries. Very important to understand the journal entries, because we can also ask of you to prepare the journal entries. So we gave you the full lease calculation here, what will be disclosed according to your maintenance expense, okay? And then what is recognized in the books according to your cash flow equalization method, okay? The straight line method. What is the cash flow amount? Well, we have determined the cash flow amount is what you physically paid. We paid 3526, and of the payment, you need to make provision for 5% that will go through your books, 1526. 1526 is the lease, the maintenance expense that is disclosable, separately disclosable, according to the standard, in your statement of financial statement of profit and loss and other comprehensive income under your profit before tax note. Colleagues, and therefore, what is your physical equalized lease expense amount for the first year? Well, it's 14,000 rand. We determined it there. But remember, this is the first year. The next year, we will have 21,000 rand and not 14,000, because then we would have had the lease payment for a full year. Okay. So what is the 14,000? Is the amount that is equalized. We've got the cash flow amount and we've got the maintenance expense. And this is a balancing figure. 30,526 minus 14 minus 1526 is your prepaid balance, exactly as what we've had in the previous question. Here is the prepayment of the balance. The journal entries for years 2 and for years 3. So years 2 and year 3, I'm not going to duplicate it. It's just the same journal. We will have the following. Well, what's the cash flow statement? What's the cash flow amount for the second year? Well, it's 2,000 times 12 for the second year is 24,000. 24,000 times 5% will give you your maintenance expense. What is your lease expense is 21,000, because we have know that the equalized amount is 21,000 rand, and the difference between all of them, 24,000 minus 21,000 minus 1,200 is 1,800. In years 4 and 5 is when the prepaid balance turns around to being an accrual balance, but we must first make it clean. We clean up the prepaid balance. You can't go and create an accrual, but you credit what was last time debited in your statement of financial position. Therefore, for years 4 and 5, your bank amount is 1,000 times 12, which is 12,000. Remember the extended period. The extended period was for 1,000 rand times 24 months. That is where we get 12,000 rand. The prepaid balance, that's a balancing figure. The lease expense for that term is 21,000, and 12,000 times 5% give you your 600 rand, and the difference is your prepaid balance that turns now around to become the difference between the balancing and the straight line figure. Now, let me go and show you this, the disclosure of this. Don't worry about the revenue and the other factors here. What we are after here is the operating expenses, okay? We are after the what was included in your operating expenses, okay? So your operating expenses is the amount that was included in your statement of your trial balance. We note now the fact that now we need to deduct 30,526, okay, as your lease amount, because that amount is what was in that amount is needs to come off of your operating expenses, okay? And your equalized, excuse me. So the 30,526, colleagues, that is your determinable cash flow amount. But we need to bring in the lease expense for the period, which is 14,000 rand. Okay, so we deduct the 35,260, which was included under your operating expenses, and we include the 14,000 as part of your lease expense for the period, as well as your maintenance expense of 1,526, okay, which include under operating expenses. How do we separately disclose them in your statement of profit and loss under your profit before tax note? Well, it's your lease expense according to your straight line method, 14,000, and your maintenance expense of 1,526, which are separately disclosable items. And that, colleagues, is how we deal with short-term leases. So if we go back to the slides, okay, as we have stated, when we deal with short-term leases, you need to be cognizant of the fact that you must be able to discuss the accounting treatment, how you will recognize the accounting treatment for the measurement of short-term leases over the straight line basis, and how do you deal with it when the cash flow amounts are greater than the equalized amounts, you will get a prepayment, and when the actual payments are less than the equalized amount, you will get the accruals. Okay, so colleagues, the short-term leases deals with exemption recognition. We will tell you that it's of low value, and IFRS 16 applies, and that the recognition exemption was applied to the question, and the lessee has decided to recognize the exception recognition. Okay, work through those examples, especially the examples that I've posted here. And it is imperative to know the theory, perform the necessary calculations, and journalize the transactions as you've seen in example 6, page 17 on Learning Unit 7. The disclosure requirements are critically important. Now, colleagues, there's not much more than what you can expect from what I've told you in this presentation slide, as well as dealing with you in the given questions. Now, you need to work through at your own time, and it's very important that if you understand our questions here that I've given to you, that's really all what you need to know to be able to address the questions coming up in your assessments, especially the written assessment form, which we deal with leases, either being financial leases or short-term leases. But I've given you the theory in the questions and apply the theory to the question to see exactly how you will deal with short-term leases. Now, colleagues, let me pause here and we can take a 10-minute break before we come back 10 minutes past 7 so that we can deal with financial leases. Colleagues, I'm going to stop here and let's just pause for a second, take a short leave toilet break, and then from there on, we can quickly discuss financial leases, where I will follow the same approach. Thank you.